Good morning. Our opening hymn can be found in the Gather hymnal under your pew, the blue hymnal under your pew. We'll open with hymn 539, hymn 539. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be His kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Sing of praise, O Lord, for He has done.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. Shout out, do not hold back. Lift up your voice like a trumpet. Announce to my people their rebellion, to the house of Jacob their sins. Yet day after day they seek me and delight to know my ways, as if they were a nation that practiced righteousness and did not forsake the ordinance of their God. They ask of me righteous judgment. They delight to draw near to God. Why do we fast, but you do not see? Why humble ourselves, but you do not notice? Look, you serve your own interest on your fast day and oppress all your workers. Look, you fast only to quarrel and to fight and to strike with a wicked fist. Such fasting as you do today will not make your voice heard on high. Is such the fast that I choose, a day to humble oneself? Is it to bow down the head like a bulrush and to lie in sackcloth and ashes? Will you call this a fast, a day acceptable to the Lord? Is not this the fast that I choose, to lose the bonds of injustice, to undo the thongs of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free and to break every yoke? Is it not to share your bread with the hungry and to bring the homeless poor into your house? When you see the naked, to cover them, and not to hide yourself from your own kin? Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your healing shall spring up quickly. Your vindictor shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your guard. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, "Here I am." If you remove the yoke from among you, the pointing of the finger, the speaking of evil, if you offer your food to the hungry and satisfy the needs of the afflicted, then your light shall rise in the darkness, and your gloom be like the noonday. The Lord will guide and continually will guide you continually and satisfy your needs in parched places and make your bones strong, and you shall be like a watered garden, like a spring of water, whose water never fail. Your ancient ruins shall be rebuilt, and you shall rise up the fountains of many generations. You shall be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of streets to live in. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Descendants will be white.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. When I came to you, brothers and sisters, I did not come proclaiming the mystery of God to you in lofty words or wisdom. For I decided to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. And I came to you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. My speech and my proclamation were not with plausible words of wisdom, but with the demonstration of the Spirit and of power, so that your faith might rest not on human wisdom, but on the power of God. Yet among the mature, we do speak wisdom, though it is not wisdom of this age or of the rulers of this age who are doomed to perish. But we speak God's wisdom, secret and hidden, which God decreed before ages for our glory. None of the rulers of this age understood this, for if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, what no eye has seen, no ear heard, nor the human heart conceived, what God has prepared for those who love him. These things God has revealed to us through the Spirit. For the Spirit searches everything, even the depths of God. For what human being knows what is truly human, except the human spirit that is within? So also no one comprehends what is truly God's, except the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit that is from God, so that we may understand the gifts bestowed on us by God. And we speak of these things in words not taught by human wisdom, but taught by the Spirit, interpreting spiritual things to those who are spiritual. Those who are unspiritual do not receive the gifts of God's Spirit, for they are foolishness to them, and they are unable to understand them because they are spiritually discerned. Those who are spiritual discern all things, and they are themselves subject to no one else's scrutiny. For who has known the mind of the Lord so as to instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thank you. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "You are the salt of the earth. But if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth pass away, not one letter, not one stroke of a letter, will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you, unless your righteousness exceeds that of the scribes and Pharisees, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
For 30 years, Dr. Stephanie Lee Harris lived and breathed early childhood development, rearing up youngsters and rearing up new teachers. Then, once that was over and done with, she became a hospice chaplain. From the beginning of life to the end of life, a very particular skill set, wouldn't you say? It was with this very particular skill set that Stephanie joined Lucia and me and went to Colombia and has just returned. And today we get to hear about how she took passion and her particular skill set and went to Colombia. Stephanie?
Good morning.
Good morning.
It is said in many ways, every day, by people of all faiths, that God is all around us, or that something has been life-altering, transforming, or has just impacted their lives forever. Lucia, Mother Cynthia, and I just returned from a mission trip to Colombia. I now understand what I once viewed as hokey or trite comments will have a place inside of me forever. God was indeed all around us, and the trip was life-altering, transforming, and impacted my life in such ways that I will continue to explore this experience for a long time. On our first day, Lucia asked us if we minded a 2-hour drive up into the mountains on a dirt road to bring school supplies and clothes to young children the next day. I was fine with it. I figured I'd see some local sights, see beautiful vistas, and I always bring a novel to read. What was not to mind? What I didn't realize was that often the narrow road wasn't there. There were no baños, bathrooms, and it was bumpy. Motorcycles roared by us on occasion. People walked up and down the roads. Trucks with produce or too many people on board stopped so that one car could pass at a time. But then as I would think these thoughts, a mercado, a store, or a house, or even a small school would appear, and I would wonder instead, what had brought these brave people to this mountainside, settle families there, and have limited access to what we take for granted? We finally arrived at the end of the road to a group of about 40, counting their families. The children were waiting for a sign to welcome us. We were seated in chairs as they sang for us. Hello, God, you are all around us. I watched your donated clothes and your school supplies being handed out while Mother and I added notebooks to the backpacks you provided. I watched children ooing over backpacks that they will have to take care of for a year or more. I was reminded that backpack buying was a new school experience yearly for my children. It is a rite of passages at the Harrises, as well as a rite for a newly used book bag. I have always taken book bag buying for granted. And school supplies? I was reminded that our boys order school supplies from a company, and they appear in the fall packaged and ready to use. We don't even have to go to Target. Lucia had hot dogs ready for the brood to eat and soda to drink. And in today's gospel reading, Matthew says, "Let your light shine before others so that you may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven." Mother and I were good followers, tentatively moving forward as needed, but Lucia, firmly and unafraid and sure-footed, walked this walk as she gave glory to God. After everything had been given out, I sat outside and hugged children who reached out their arms to me for a thank you hug. Their moms stood shyly behind them and thanked us as well. We were treated like royalty, and it made me feel uncomfortable, but appreciated. As I sat there, I watched the mountains change color in the light, clouds move by, children playing and then moving into silliness as they exploded into happiness around us. Many of them still wore their backpacks. I felt blessed, but Lucia, I was ready to go. Now, Lucia came outside and told us that the leader had cooked for us and that we needed to stay. I was feeling old and exhausted. It was now raining, and we had 2 hours plus back to our town over bumps and through mountain darkness. But there was another God moment yet to come. The leader of the church had killed and prepared a chicken for us in our honor. She and some others had cooked us a full meal. There was enough room for the three of us to sit and eat together at the table. But the ladies stood out of the way, smiling and watching us sit down. And Lucia motioned to them to come forward. And we joined hands and we prayed together in two languages on that mountain while the children ran giggling in and out of the house. God was in that house and among us, and I know it for sure. The next day, we put together more backpacks and school supplies to go to another area of Colombia. Lucia doesn't let you sleep in. This time, we were off to an Episcopal church. She had arranged this visit before we left Coral Springs with the church deacon. "You are the light of the world," says Matthew. The children there sat in a small building, chapel, and sang us a welcome song. Lucia had brought pizza for them, and one child commented to her that he had never had it before. He was 11 years old. There was no parish hall, there was no school, there was no water, and there was no baño for me. But there was a lot of praise to God and to us for coming. When our time together was over, we had another surprise. The deacon had somehow grasped that I was a female chaplain. And he loved that Cynthia, the female priest, had come to Colombia. He had just opened an Episcopal assisted living facility a week before, and he wanted us to see it. Since those are the facilities I work for in hospice, I wanted to see it as well. We drove a distance to an old garage, which doubled as an Episcopal chapel. We visited and went into the main building. It was not a hospice. It was housing for the homeless. He had arranged for 12 homeless and religious men to go to a facility during the day and come back in the evening for prayer
a meal, and to sleep. He built up this mission by himself, and through Lucia, he had found out about her and her work, and she had found about him and his work. Matthew says, "No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under a bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all of the house." We were asked to tour. It was small and hardly clean by most standards, but the faith, love, and respect that these men and their deacon had for one another was present. When I asked if they needed anything, we were told that they could use fitted sheets for the beds, because some of the beds did not have sheets on them yet, but only the fitted sheet, because there were no dryers. Now the third day, Lucia took pity on me. We went to a town where she used to live, and there we met at a friend's house by an after-school group of students who sat us down and acted as though we were celebrities and performed a song for us using sign language. One of the children there, who was unable to speak but can sign, did so with gusto. I was told later that the others had learned songs for him. Afterwards, the children waited patiently for their special surprise from our church, their uniforms. They were handed out one at a time, and Lucia explained to them that they were from our parish members. You did that. Each child received one, and then the leader brought them up, and they were told to say thank you. The first one to come up to me stuck her head towards me, and I thought maybe she wanted to be blessed, so I did. Each child then came up to Cynthia or myself and put out their foreheads. Later, I thought, I hope that's what they wanted. Now, the best was yet to come. In a surprise move, my amazing friend and priest got up and spoke to them in sign language. As an aside, how long have I been with her on all of our adventures together? And I've never known she could sign. The young boy was over the moon. Was this transformative? Yes. My impression of this experience is that we are all blessed here at St. Mary Magdalene. First, Lucia listened to the word of God and moved forward on her own for 9 years to create a special mission where she could service those less fortunate from her homeland. And when she was ready to have us be a part of this mighty mission, we wrapped our arms around her here at the church, and we raised money, and we collected backpacks and supplies for her. And Cynthia and I went along with her devotion to offer her friendship, support, and a deeper understanding of what it is that God asks us to do in his name. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. As we remain standing with a tear in our eye, let us affirm our faith by saying together the Nicene Creed, found on page 358. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Today's Prayers of the People is Form 4, found on page 388. Let us pray for the Church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and your glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Let us at this time lift up those who are ill, those who are suffering in any way, those on our hearts.
Ask for your continued prayers for Richard Rapp, for your continued prayers for Rob Hill and his family.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled. And we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom.
At this time, we lift up special prayers for Julie Hill and Godfrey Bernard, praying thanksgiving for their lives. May their souls rest in peace.
O Lord, our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. My brothers and sisters, may the peace of the Lord be always with you.
Okay. Good morning and welcome all. Phyllis, do you have a guest you want to introduce? We have guests with Phyllis today. Rob, welcome.
Before I introduce our visitors, I'd like to thank the very family for everything that comes from your family. My wife passed a few weeks ago, and this gentleman, I've known his wife twice, long time, but I've known him for 63 years. He and I went to high school together. Reverend Frederick C.
Are there any other guests this morning who would like to be introduced? Okay. For the prosaic now, we have four cars that are completely blocking some other cars, and they need to be moved. So if you have a red Mitsubishi BK-UK-22 or BMW EYPT44 or a Honda CRV 767 TXZ or a blue Elantra, I think, JAICR9. If one of those is your cars, could you please go move them over here? Okay. What? It's back here?
Yes, on that side.
Okay.
All right. The stewardship committee is out for the beamer, I think, right now.
Okay. All right. So, welcome. Move your car. Now, There will be coffee hour today. It will be in the parish hall or in the open area just before you go into the parish hall. Kids of Love is here today with an amazing array of mostly but not entirely antique glass and crystal and china. Kids of Love is a ministry that was started by a grade school kid to help children with cancer. So advocacy and outreach of St. M&M will be splitting the proceeds with Kids of Love. So there's coffee and pastries and gluten-free over there, and you can peruse. So that means that you can buy a lovely vase in order to have something in which to put the roses, which you will purchase from the youth group, Hannah, who has the order forms for roses.
Okay. Good morning. It's time for our annual roses for Valentine's Day. One dozen of roses would be $20, six roses, $14, one rose, $2, and it will be delivered on Sunday, February 12th after the 10:30 service. Thank you for supporting the youth group.
Okay, terrific. Two birds, one stone this morning. Dr. Park, it looks like you have something to say. No. Okay, are there any birthdays, wedding anniversaries, or travelers for blessings this morning? You're welcome to come forward. Molly, okay. Oh, all of these are birthdays? Oh my goodness. Okay. Okay. Oh God, our times are in your hand. Look with favor, we pray, on these your servants as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace and strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their lives through Christ our Lord. Amen. Congratulations. Molly, how old are you now? Seven. Oh, very good, Molly. It's a great age. Okay. Weddings? How many?
14.
Good. 11. Are you all traveling? All traveling. Okay. Hold right hands. Okay. Oh God, you have so consecrated the covenant of marriage that in it is represented the spiritual unity between Christ and his church. Send therefore your blessing upon these your servants, that they may so love, honor, and cherish each other in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessing and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. Congratulations. Congratulations. Okay. Oh God, our Heavenly Father, whose glory fills the whole creation and whose presence we find wherever we go, preserve those who travel, surround them with your loving care, protect them from every danger, and bring them in safety to their journey's end. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Traveling mercies. And of course, I have a whole new, that means a whole new thing to me now that I have been on a road in Colombia. Traveling mercies.
I wanted to say one thing. Father Bruno, so you're headed back to the Dominican Republic?
Yes.
So you're going back to Haiti. Okay. Father Bruno has been worshiping with us for about the past 6 weeks, I believe, and you have helped us immensely in our service, not only here at the 10:30 service, but also most especially at the 12:30 service with our Spanish. And you have urged me to continue in my Spanish lessons, which I shall. That's what we should do. But I want to thank you on behalf of this entire congregation for all of our services, for all that you have done and continue to do here at this parish, and all that you do at your parish and your school and your hospital. And we pledge to continue to support and help you. So thank you, and God bless you. You are welcome. God bless you.
Let us with gladness present the alms and oblations of our lives and labor unto the Lord. Thank you.
Lord be with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right
and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because in the mystery of the Word made flesh, you have caused a new light to shine in our hearts, to give the knowledge of your glory in the face of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. As our Savior Christ has taught us, we now pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Alleluia! Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the peace.
Alleluia. Gifts of God for the people of God. Thank you. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Would the Eucharistic visitor please come forward?
Let us send her out together as she goes to visit those who are ill and homebound. In the name of this congregation, we send you forth bearing these holy gifts, that those to whom you go may share with us in the communion of Christ's body and blood. We who are many are one body, because we all share one bread, one cup.
May Christ, the Son of God, be manifest in you, that your lives may be a light to the world, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you this day and always.
Amen. Amen. The Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.